Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to do it-inspired nails. It's going to be scary. So, on the lovely Vanessa, we've already put tips on. We've done prep, which means we've removed the surface shine from the nail. I am going to wipe over with gel residue wipe off solution because we've had dinner and there might be some pasta or oil or some kind of
eat
thing.
Pasta with my fingers.
I know, but I just thought I'd just make sure that they are nice and clean. Yeah, no pasta. Right, so what we need to do now is dehydrate with the nail prep dehydrator. Just on that natural nail, don't need to waste product by putting it on the tip because it won't do anything. And then we're going to use the Ultra Bond Acid Primer. So on those two nails, we're going to do Mega White. Oh my God, did you see that fuzzy? I nearly encapsulated a black fuzzy in the white. That would not have been good. So we're going to pattern press this to the end of that tip. Next bead, you want to drag that down on top of the previous bead. Trying to make sure I've got that apex built up. So with the Mega White, you can build structure with it. It's not like the powders. Like these ones in the little pots, generally the coloured powders generally are just for colour and not structure, whereas Mega White you can build structure all day long and it will have lots and lots of strength. I'm going to do the same on this one. So this is a two bead application, so we get the bulk of it done in those two beads. Notice I'm tipping the finger down slightly. Tipping the finger down will draw the product down the nail, and then we can pattern press as it starts to polymerize. Pattern press it, pull it down the nail with a little bit firmer pressure. Second bead, get your cuticle nice and neat, and then you can drag that down on top of the previous bead. How has that even fell over? But it's been there like that for ages, and that bottle's fell over and knocked that off.
Because you knocked it early.
When? Are you sure?
I am.
No,
sure.
It's it.
I think it's it.
It's it.
It's gonna come and tell me things are floating, and I need to go and see the floating boats.
The floating boats. I haven't seen the new one.
I haven't.
Is this a good time to say I've seen none? Just don't watch horror films.
Do you know what? I'm not into horror and I haven't seen any of the new ones. I've seen the old one a long time ago and can't really remember them. My sister, who was 13, loves them. And I know she's not supposed to watch them because she's 13. However, she has and she absolutely loves them. She loves a good horror. Abby loves a good horror. I'm not into horrors, are you?
I like a good horror, but they're few and far between.
You're saying this one is not a good horror?
I haven't seen it, so, but I did love the mini-series one, like the original.
What was that? Oh yeah, got a big blue, it got like a balloon head. Mm. I prefer the makeup and how, you know, the new It looks compared to the old one.
Kim Curry, I prefer.
Yeah.
It was more fun looking. This one
looks
sinister. Counts
are
supposed to look fun, but be sinister. In my opinion.
Yeah. So I'm going to pinch that and I'm going to pinch the end of it as well. And then what I'm doing is I'm doing these two and then I'm doing this one because they don't have any glitter in. If you're doing glitters, I want to sort of do that lastly, because I'm going to have bits of glitter all over my paper, and it just stops me from changing over this desk paper all the time. So we're going to come to the thumb, because the thumb is going to be black. I am going to put a thin bead of clear acrylic onto that natural nail, so I have great adhesion. You want it very thin, because the black is not a structure powder. This will give you the best adhesion. So I'm going to pick up the black. It's highly pigmented. Pull it down, sweep this back a little bit. And don't get me wrong, it does have some strength. It's just not quite as strong as the core range, which is like your clear, your mega white, and all those cover pinks, the many, many, many cover pinks that Naio nails do. And let's get this cuticle area nice and neat. You don't need to do it really thick, because it is highly pigmented. You just want to make sure you've got a nice, neat border around the edge of the nail. I'm going to encapsulate now with clear. So this is crystal clear. This is going to give strength. You're going to build your apex. These two are going to have red glitter on. I want to incorporate glitter. I know they're going to be it, scary, kind of inspired nails, but I still want them to look pretty. So we're going to use red glitter. We're going to lay down a thin layer of pure red and use the glitters as well. So we'll use pure red. We will use a thin layer of clear like we have on the other nails, but I'm going to use all these glitters, even a bit of cracked mylar, and I'm going to pop them in a pot. I like to do this because it makes my job easier. We're going to pop that in with mylar and some finer red glitter. I love mixing my glitters, gives them more texture, and I believe it makes them even sparklier. So we're going to give that a bit of a shake. And we've got our nice glitter there. Love it. So we're going to pop that there. So a maximum adhesion, a thin layer of clear. And the same on the pinky. Then we're going to use the pure red. We just want to do this nice and thin and kind of paint it on. It just gives a really nice background colour. Same on the pinky. You can pick up a bead of clear and then touch my glitter that I've pre-mixed. Give it a swoosh around, and then we can start putting that over the top of that red, and you'll see why that red's important to the background, because it sort of fills in any gaps where there is no glitter. So a little bit more glitter, so you want to put that on and move it around and make sure you're putting it in the places that you want it, because we want to cover the nail. And then we're going to encapsulate with crystal clear, pointing the finger down, pulls it away from the cuticle, and then as we start to move down, we straighten the finger up. Same on this one. Right, so I'm going to file these now. I'm just going to buff these, make them nice and smooth. when I'm doing tips, I always like to check the underneath, because sometimes when you're filing, you get like some little bits that kick on the inside that you haven't quite filed away. So I always like to run, you know, a finger or a thumb underneath and just give it a buff as well. And that'll just free that up. Dust them off, and the rest of your hand. Then I'm going to wipe it over with acetone. The acetone will also smooth the top layer. So you can see now why I've used white, because we're going to use this image as our little inspiration. We're going to copy that to my best of my ability. So I've got a damp sponge and I'm going to put my paints onto that. It's going to help keep them wet. I nearly said dry then, and that would not be the right word. Would you trust that face? Would you trust that face to take you down the drain to watch some paper boats floating? Don't think you'd trust that face. It's not a trustworthy face, is it that?
Nope.
It's not. So I'm kind of sketching out the eye at the moment. I find it easier to work on my right hand side.
You mean the side people can't see with this camera?
Sorry. So that's why I've flipped the thing around. And then he's got this like, he has this like crease, which is where his eyebrows are, or would have been. It's as if somebody's like removed his eyebrows and left a scar. Mm. It's weird, I don't know who came up with that, but it makes me think somebody's said, those eyebrows, we don't like them, we're gonna get rid of them, and they cut them out. I don't know if that's true.
Would you seem a little bit extreme just for not liking eyebrows, but
yeah, or maybe he loved his eyebrows that much and
framed them.
Because he was so nasty to somebody, they cut his eyebrows out. Maybe that's another film in itself. Maybe I'm just a bit strange.
Maybe it doesn't happen.
Well, yeah, because it says it, this is supposed to be like the last one, isn't it? Like, that's it now.
Well, in the end game.
In the what?
Well, the mini series was like two parts.
Yeah.
Not, yeah, but it was like, it was both of these films mixed into one. So it kept jumping between them, young and old, young and old, young and old. Where this one, the first one was them young, and this second one was them old, wasn't it?
Don't know. Not watched any of them. I love how we do these film inspired nails and I've not actually watched.
It would normally help. Film.
I just can't do the horror, it's too scary. Because I tend to watch films at night when I'm in bed, and if I watch a horror, then I had to turn one off once. What was it called? Ooh. Can't think what it's called. He's coming or something like that. She had to turn it off. I was like, and I've watched Get Out. What a load of rubbish that is. Is it supposed to be horror though? I'm sure it is supposed to be. Are you sure?
100%.
What is it then?
It's a lot of crap.
It is, isn't it? I was really disappointed.
It was more like a comedy.
That's how I felt. I thought, this is rubbish. Whoever's written this, you need sack, mate. I was not impressed. So we're giving him some bags, because he clearly hasn't had his Botox. And we don't want this eyeliner to be perfect, because it's not very good at it. And you'd think, after all these years of doing it, I think it'd be really good. Wouldn't it? Not so good then.
It's probably as good as I am.
Right, we need a bit of red, but we want a tiny bit of black in it. Just a deep, make it really deep. I'm going to add this in here. Oh no, a little bit deeper. A little bit deeper. That's more. It's like a rouge noir. It's amazing when you have white face paint on, or you know, a white face like he does, how red the, you know, the fleshy parts of inside your eye actually look. Clearly talking from experience, and it is amazing how yellow your teeth look. But I do think he does need to go to the dentist. I think, you know, he's got some issues there with his teeth.
Should have come with me yesterday.
Yeah. So we've added a little bit of red. So I'm just adding little bits of shading. And the main part I want to get right is the sort of these lines coming through like this. We'll do his eyes last, because they scare me a little bit. I'm not gonna lie. So do you think it is actually a full-on horror, or is it a little bit like a bit of a comedy?
Well, it's definitely got humorous moments in it, because it's got a clown in it, but it's definitely a horror. 100%, written by Stephen King.
Yeah, and he's the man. Mm-hmm. Have you ever seen Thinner?
Yes.
That's weird, isn't it?
Mm, I read the book a long time ago as well.
It's a weird one, though. It does make me question the mental health of the people that write these films. Maybe that's why they're so good at it. Is Saw classed as a horror?
Thriller. Yes, that's more of a...
thriller?
No, it's definitely a
psychological thriller.
No, it's more of a like a slasher horror type thing. I know it's not like normally when you associate a slasher, you talk about like Michael Myers or
Kill them, so them.
Like Halloween or Freddy Krueger.
Yeah,
but I think I would class that as, I mean, some people call it torture porn.
Really?
Yeah. But yeah, it's definitely a horror film.
Because I watch that. I'm good with that. Yeah, I can watch
that's
that.
That's more about like the tension and the like.
Yeah.
And then seeing the gore.
Yeah.
You know? Whereas I associate horrors with a lot of supernatural stuff.
Yeah, like the ghosts.
Witches and ghosts.
Yeah, that's just too much. I can't cope with it.
And
I can't be watching that stuff.
I mean, some of the recent good ones, what's it called? Oh, for the life of me, I forgot what it was actually called.
What, it's been on at the cinema?
Sorry?
Has it been on at cinema?
Oh yeah, like a few years ago. There was the Annabelle character.
Yeah, I've not watched that.
Yeah, but I'm talking about the action.
Come on, Ness, don't you know?
What the hell is it called? What she was... The first movie that it was... The Conjuring.
Oh, yeah.
There's been like three of them.
Yeah, well...
The first one
was Sister Abby
brilliant.
Loves them as well.
The first one was absolutely brilliant. Second one was okay.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't watched the third one, or if there is a third one, I'm not sure. Oh yeah, that was the one with the nun.
What's that called, the nunning?
It was called the nun.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
You were dead impressed with that, then, weren't you?
The nunning. It's called the nun. Wow.
And then they made them terrible Annabelle films, which were like spin-offs of it. The nun was a spin-off of it. I don't know if they're doing a third one or if they already have. Oh yeah, it's coming out next year. I mean, our class, like Alien, that's a real horror.
No. What, sci-fi horror?
Yeah. But you've got like a ship with about what? I think it's about 7 of them on it.
Mm-hmm.
And then this alien loose on it. That's a horror. I mean, that last 15 minutes of that film is pure tension. Sci-fi horror is my favourite, I think. Supernatural horror and sci-fi horror.
It's like, you know, these programmes that you can watch about real life ghosts, because they're real, obviously. Mm. Can't cope, make me bad. Can't watch them. I think I tend to watch films. If I watch a film that's, you know, that is horror or, which is very rare, but if I do, I tend to look at it and think, oh, the makeup's really cool on that. How did they do that? Like, oh, that must have just come hours in makeup. I don't, but if it's like a ghost one.
Yeah.
Oh, I can't cope with that. Can't cope with that. Yeah, not good with that. Yeah.
I didn't catch that.
No. See, we never asked enough things. Do you know what I mean? It's weird, isn't it?
Like when Alexa pipes up a tone.
Yeah.
Hey Siri. No, she doesn't want to listen.
Yeah, she's having nothing.
Hey Siri. What's your favourite horror movie? I don't really have a favourite, but I hear that 2001 A Space Odyssey got some good reviews. That's not a horror film. I mean, there is. I suppose there is a bit of horror in it.
I wouldn't have said that was a horror film.
It's not a horror film.
Siri, what are you on about? It's coming together nicely. So we need to make sure we mix a little bit of this black into the red to create a really dark red for this mouse here. The teeth will sit on top of this. We want to get the dark laid down first of all. And this dark colour will also create the separation between the top lip and the opening of the mouth. I'm going to fill the eyes with white and then I'm going to let that dry. While that's drying, I can do the teeth. So we need a bit of that yellow, a little bit of white, a little bit of that brown. Oh, that was a minging teeth. Right, do you know when you have your teeth whitened and you've got that colour chart? I'm not sure. I don't know if they have it this minging colour. Down this brown and just add a little bit of that black and decay to the teeth. While that yellow is drying in the eyes, we're going to move on to this nail and we're going to write it in that really jaggedy kind of font. It's not a font, is it? I'm sure you wouldn't find that on Adobe Illustrator or whatever it is the font would be on.
I found something similar to that.
Would you? Let's come back to these eyes. It's beautiful eyes, so beautiful. Right, so we want a little bit of red in this yellow to make it a little bit more orange around the edge of the eye. You can just see a little bit of the pupil. Wouldn't like me to on the dark alleyway. On the thumb, we're going to do the balloons. And there are two balloons because it's part two. Possibly the last one, apparently. Not done many parts, have we? We don't want it to be completely solid because the balloon has some transparency to it. I'm going to overlap the balloons. Right, I'm going to matte top coat the white using the ultra matte top coat. So both nails that have the white on and the crazy design. Sparkly ones are going to have the gel top coat, which is perfect for over the top of acrylic. Don't want to use this over the top of gel polish because it will crack and you don't want that. Put them in there. Now, for a bit of gel polish, I'm going to use Heartbreaker and we will use some of Siren, which is our single letter. So, we're going to take some Heartbreaker first and do some blood. It wouldn't be Halloween if we didn't have a little bit of blood. That in the lamp. So now with the glitter gel polish, I'm going to put that over the top. So I really needed the Heartbreaker colour in the background because we're literally just going to trickle this glitter over the top, and we need that red in the background to sort of fill in the gaps where the glitter won't be. And I like the blood with glitter because obviously I bleed glitter. Because I think I inhale that much. Let's matte top coat the balloons and pop that in the lamp. And this one we're going to put some blood coming from the bottom. And then we're going to go over with the glitter again. I actually really like this over the black. I think it's really effective. And then we're going to use, we're using so many products, the Urban Graffiti top coat. So we're not going to use the gel top coat, we're using the Urban Graffiti one because I'm going to put this over the top of the gel polish. If we use this one, it would crack. So you want to use the Urban Graffiti one because it's got flexibility just like the gel. Can I have your hand, please? Okay. We're going to do that on the blood on this one. And we'll do it on this as well. And it also makes it even more raised so you get that embossed look. Let's finish with some cuticle oil. How cool is that? Are you going to be alright with him on your nail at night? Is he going to scare you?
Might be a bit.
Might be like, Hey all guys, hope you've enjoyed this video. Everything that I've used today will be listed below. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. And all that shebang. I don't know what that bit was for. Just very animated sometimes with my hands. I am sorry. See you later. Yes, definitely going backwards from now. Yes. That's all.